Hello there, good evening. It is Thursday, February 27th, I believe. Yes, 2020, 6:39 p.m. It's been a few days, I believe, since I've done a video, so I know there's a lot going on, especially with the coronavirus, the COVID-19. And so I've been in lots of prayer about that, and lots of prayer for our officials, etc. So I'm going to try to stay focused, and I'll just get into the word here and prayer, and whatever God has me say or whatever I say, we'll see. My psalms for today are Psalm 131, 132, 133, 134, and 135. Let me see. Psalm 134 has three verses in it. Behold, bless ye the Lord, all ye servants of the Lord, which by night stand in the house of the Lord, and it's night, definitely. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and bless the Lord. The Lord made heaven and earth. The Lord that made heaven and earth bless thee out of Zion. Okay, praise the Lord. So thank you for your blessings, Lord. Psalm 131, three verses again. That's cool, huh? Lord, my heart is not haughty, nor my eyes lofty, neither do I exercise myself in great matters or in things too high for me. Surely I have behaved and quieted myself as a child that is weaned of his mother. My soul is even as a weaned child. Let Israel hope in the Lord from henceforth and forever. Father, we just come to you right now and we lift up our lives to you. One thing about these videos I like to do is to just stay on track. No matter what's going on, I like to get into the Word, starting out with Psalms. And so, Lord, let's go over to Proverbs 27, since it's the 27th of the month. Yes. Proverbs 27. Let's just read a little bit of the Proverbs. Boast not thyself of tomorrow, for thou knowest not what a day may bring forth. Let another man praise thee, and not thine own mouth, a stranger, and not thine own lips. A stone is heavy, and the sand weighty, but a fool's wrath is heavier than them both. Wrath is cruel, and anger is outrageous, but who is able to stand before envy? Open rebuke is better than secret love. Faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deceitful. The full soul loatheth an honeycomb, but to the hungry soul every bitter thing is sweet. As a bird that wandereth from her nest, so is a man that wandereth from his place. I'm going to stop right there. If you want to read the rest of Proverbs, you can. Of course, you can do whatever God has you do. Let's go over here to Matthew 20. There are 28 chapters in Matthew, I believe. So let's go over to Matthew 27. Okay, see how that is? Then we get into the Word a little bit each day, if you can, okay? Matthew 27. You know, I don't plan these videos generally, okay? I like to do spontaneous so that I can always do spontaneous when needed, okay? Matthew 27. When the morning was come, all the chief priests and elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. And when they had bound him, they led him away. Remember, Jesus went to the cross for us. It was purpose that he went to the cross, okay? And when they had bound to die for our sins, he was the sacrifice, okay? And when they had bound him, they led him away and delivered him to Pontius Pilate, the governor. Then Judas, which had betrayed him, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself, and brought again the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders, saying, I have sinned in that I have betrayed the innocent blood. And they said, What is that to us? See thou to that. And he cast down the pieces of silver in the temple, and departed, and went and hanged himself. And the chief priests took the silver pieces, and said, It is not lawful for to put them into the treasury, because it is the price of blood. And they took counsel, and bought with them the potter's field to bury strangers in, wherefore that field was called the field of blood unto this day. Then was Jesus fulfilled that which was spoken by Jeremy the prophet, saying, And they took the 30 pieces of silver of the price of him that was valued, whom they of the children of Israel did value. I'm going to stop right there. Lord, I thank you for your word, Lord. Thank you, God, for your word. I just come to you right now and lift up this situation with the coronavirus. I come against it in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, Father God, for helping us all through this in the name of Jesus. We come against the stock market crashing in the name of Jesus. Hey, Lord, we're all ready to meet you in the air. If you're coming soon, only the Father knows. So we will continue to occupy until you come and help people, help the authorities, help doctors, the medical people. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bind panic in the name of Jesus. We for this particular